Alright guys, what's poppin', what's good, you know what's up. That's really awkward. Okay. So like today's video, like I have nothing else to do. Like I asked people on my Snapchat asking me questions because I want to do a Q&A today, and no one asked me like asked me questions so I can answer. So I was like, you know, like what, like I'm gonna do a pet tag. Go over there. I'm gonna do a pet talk today because like I have 5 pets. I know that's not that much, like for me, but like that's all I got. So I'm gonna start right now, like with my perra, like perrona Rubita, who's right down here. Like, you know, like this is my perra Rubita. Like, she's a chihuahua. She's a. she's honestly my best friend because she gets me, you know. Like, people got her ugly, but that's what people call me, so we're like the perfect duo. Like, Rubita, Ruby, look at this face. You see, that's the perfect face. So she's about to turn 2 in December. She's a chihuahua thank you for the kisses. She's a blonde chihuahua. Her name's Rubita, which means blondie. Her name's Rubita Castro. I got her. Fun fact, I got her when I lived in Beverly, Massachusetts, in a house. And pretty much what happened was, my mom used to work from 3, so when I got out of school from 1 in the morning, and I was home a lot by myself, so she got me a dog, and it was this dog. Neighbors upstairs, their dogs just had given birth like a month ago, so my mom was like, oh, can you bring down, she's the run, and then my mom was like, can you bring down, the only one that they had left, but they were thinking about just giving her away. And pretty much what happened was they brought her down, and I spent like 2 days with her, and then they told my mom $700, and I was like, well, we're not gonna spend $700. So my mom just paid like $300 and just let it go, and they just let it go because they were gonna give her away anyways. So that's her name. Yeah, she just listens to like a lot of commands in Spanish. She knows come, she knows, and high five, and that's it. Man, high five. High five. She's paying attention to another animal I'm a bingo. But man, high five. High five. Good girl. Kissy. Ow, oh, to get me to punch her nose. Let me kissy. Yeah, she just likes acting crazy when I ask her for kisses. And then she's really friendly with other animals. Like, I consider her, like, she's one of my companion animal. And then, because I also, like, when I'm by myself, I get anxiety and I start freaking out. And I'm just, like, you know. So, yeah. And she understands me. Like, it's weird, but she understands me. I'm just going to say that. So, the next clip. So, recap. Her name's Rubita, but English is Blondie. She's about to turn 2 in December. She's a blonde chihuahua. I think she's a deer head or an apple head. I don't know. Like, I think she's a deer head. Yeah, she's, like, my best friend. So, next clip is gonna be an animal that's right next to me that's really bothering me. And is trying to dig a hole into, like, concrete. I don't know.
Okay, so this is the next pet that I have. Pet friend. Oh my god, look at your nails. Okay, I got off topic. So this is Athena. She's a bearded dragon. I don't know what morph she is. All I know is that she's super beautiful and cute. And then, that's Isis. I think the owner told me that she was 1 year old, I believe. So, she's currently, like, she's laying a lot of eggs, but they're not fertilized since she hasn't been with male. A thing that, so her, like, cons and negatives, same thing. Pros and cons about her. A pro is that she's lovable. She's like a little puppy. Like, I cannot be with her sister on the bed by herself without her wanting going onto the bed with us. Another thing, she's really energetic. Like, the most energetic bearded dragon I ever, like, saw. She's calm right now, but then she just starts, like, running around, starts scratching, running around, you know? She literally tried to dig a hole into my bed sheet. And I feel like she has a little bump there, or some little something there. I believe that it's just cause she really like bumps. What a problem is, I don't know how to fix this. Is that she she keeps on running into her, like, her enclosure, and try to, like, cause the enclosure is next to my bed, so when I sit next to that, she just keeps on trying to run towards me, keeps on bumping her head onto the enclosure, which I feel really bad, but I don't know how to fix that. And yeah, another thing is I think that she's blind for some reason. I don't know why. Just when she sleeps, she only sees with one eye open, and I've been checking her, like, I literally spend the night, like, looking at her, because they usually turn on, I usually turn on their red light, their tank red light, I usually turn on the tank red light at like 8:30, usually, yeah. And I leave because when it's hot, I sleep in the living room, so the air is there. But I usually just spend the night watching Netflix in my room. And like at 4, my mom goes to work. I just go to sleep and I just see both of them sleeping. But this one sleeps only with one eye open. And another thing that's really cute, she slept a lot today, so I hope they can do it, is when I rub their back of their head, she starts going to sleep. I don't know if you can see it. I hope she's doing, come on, baby, do it. Oh, no, she sees herself, and she's, like, mad. So, yeah. So, this is Athena. Recap, she's a bearded dragon. I do not know what morph she is. She's really energized. She likes to bump her face onto her glass. So the glass tank. And that's why I think she has that little thing there. She has no problem eating. She's currently dropping eggs. But she's a really nice bearded dragon. The only problem that I have is really energized. Likes to go out his tank, and when it's out of his tank, it just stays kind of chill. Other than that, it's perfect. I really recommend these guys. Beginner's pet, you know? Right. I literally just met her last week. I got her for free. I met her last week. Not even last week. Like, last Friday. Yeah, last week, technically. Got them Sunday. And I never met them. They literally just crawled out the tank to go onto me. And they were, like, perfect with me. So, yeah. Right, you're such a good baby. Only thing I don't like about bearded dragons is that if you don't take them a shower, they smell a lot. Like, no, they smell really bad because when their bellies especially are really dirty. Like, these is kind of dirty. I find it dirty. I don't know if to other people it's dirty, but it's kind of dirty for me. So, what I'm going to do is next video, probably in a couple future video, I'm going to, like, give you guys, like, a routine of how I take the showers. There's oil that a reptile YouTuber that I saw tries out. YouTuber that his name is Laura Leon, I think, that he tries this shampoo for bearded dragon. Apparently smells really good, so I'm gonna try it out. I'm gonna order it. Other than that, how I take them in the showers with a toothbrush. Kind of put some water. People say baby shampoo, but I just did it with water since for the first time. So since I didn't have anything, and I just kind of scrub it up and down in each scale. Like, there's a lot of scales, but like on the back and the sides, the feet, the stomach, under the tail usually. So yeah. So this is Athena, and that's Blondie back there, you know, doing the regular thing. So yeah, you see that she likes to move a lot. Bye. Come on, buddy.
Next pet that I brought out is Athena's sister. Her name's Isis. After the Egyptian god, not the terrorist organization. So leave Isis alone. You're mad annoying. She's every time. Okay, so Ruita, Blondie, every time that I bring one of them out, she just starts, like, scratching them like this, and, like, licking them and smelling, like, their butt, which is disgusting. And, like, literally, she's, like, I don't even know what you're doing, man. But other than that, let me bring her out for you guys. She's actually right next here. So this is Isis. She's the chill one of both the combo. Like, she's really chill, she's really calm, she really likes to keep to herself. She just like stays the whole entire day in one area. She's really calm. She's one of my favorites. I don't have favorites, but she's kind of really up there. What's that, baby? She's up there. Isis, come, Isis. So this is Isis. Bring the lion. This is Isis. She's a macho girl, right, Isis? Show my shoulder, baby. So she's really you see? That's what I'm saying. So, so she's really calm. I named her Isis because I was gonna name them like Athena, because I love Egyptian and Greek mythology and Mayan mythology, all that mythology. So I was gonna name it Isis, and probably Aphrodite. I think it's Aphrodite. I was gonna name them Athena and Aphrodite, but I was like, she's a little more darker, so I was like, African goddess Isis. She's really calm. She keeps to herself, as long as I know. Like, she's the first, so like at 7 o'clock, she's like knocked. She's a little chunky baby. She likes to eat a lot. She hasn't laid eggs yet, but I think she's on her way because she's getting a little big belly. Again, these eggs do not have babies inside. They're not fertilized. It's just like they just drop them out. It's kind of like a period for lizards. Look at this. Ruita, what are you doing? So, pros and cons of Isis. Ooh, Isis. Come on, buddy. Come on, girl. So let me just show her. Look at that orange beard. Okay, so pros and cons for Isis. Isis, I'm just gonna put you on the table, baby. So So Isis, the person said that they were born together, they're actually sisters. So Isis is older though. But they're both 1 year old, but Isis is older. So a pros and cons about Isis is that pros is that she's really calm. She's a calm bearded dragon. She's really calm. She stays on her hammock. She just sleeps on her hammock. She goes down. She has no problem with me. They both have no problem eating. She just goes down to use the bathroom, drink water, which is right next to her hammock, and just eat food. But other than that, the con for me is that when I pick her up, she kind of panics, which I don't know. Whenever I pick her up, she goes, "Why are you licking? Why are you licking my screen? Why are you licking my screen? You gonna take a picture? You gonna take a picture? Take a picture." Okay, so, whenever I pick her up, she kind of, moves her tail like that. And I feel like she's just trying to find, like, a good position to get, like, be at. But other than that, she's really good. Girl, I love her eyes and her beard. Oh, come on, baby.
So I'm gonna focus on her. She's a really beautiful baby. God, you're so beautiful. And they do not smell. Like, I clean them every... I wash them. I wash them every week, like, with a toothbrush. Kind of wet it a little bit and just, like, pass it through the scales. Why are you thinking that there's food on the table? You're hungry? You're hungry? I like baby talking my pets because I'm their dad. Like, they depend on me. So they're like my little babies. But other than that, I just got. Thank you for the kissy on the nose. High five. Oh, that's a kissy, not a high five. Good girl. So other than that, Isis, where are you going, honey? Other than that, yeah, these are all my pets and my little babies, my little friends. Because these are, like, really the friends that I stick with. I mean, obviously. But I feel like they understand me more than my friends do. But not that, like, my friends don't understand me. They really do. They're really good. I'm really picky about who my friends are. It's just these guys are really dope, fun, really nice, you know? But other than that, so this was my pet tag. Recap on Isis. Recap on Athena. Recap on Blondie. I know those are only three. I have two other geckos. They currently are, like, in a hospital stage. Not really hospital stage yet. My house is just that they have problem eating. At least one of them do. The other one's really, like, fat. So pretty much the situation. Okay, one's mac and cheese. They're leopard geckos. One problem is that Mac is the chubbier one. No, Cheese is the chubbier one. Cheese likes eating all the food. And Mac is really, really skinny and weak. Pretty much what happened is they were born together in the same enclosure together. Everything's good. They have really bad separation anxiety, like Isis and Athena. But pretty much I try separating them to eat. And just they didn't want to eat. Both of them didn't want to eat. And I put them together. And Mac, which is the weak one, they're both girls. Mac, which is the weak one, she was kind of woo. She's kind of pretty much she would just eat like one or two worms, and then Cheese would eat like five. And if I separate them, I have a problem. But what I try to do now is tonsil feed them. I'm starting that tomorrow. So yeah. Are you looking at me like that? Literally looking at me like, hold on. Other than that, that's the situation they're in. Two leopard geckos, macaroni and cheese. I try to separate them. Unfortunately, they do not want to cooperate, so I would have to separate them forcefully, which means that I'm gonna buy a separate tank, and they would learn how to live without each other, which is really sad because that's the only way that Mac would, like, survive. Macaroni and cheese, but it's mac and cheese for short. But that's the only way Macaroni would survive because she's way too skinny. Of course, they're gonna see each other. They'll be able to play with each other. Just that I want them to be at their best and at their prime so that they can keep on living, because my aunt gave them to me, and I don't want to give her the bad news that a pet that she gave me passed away, you know, because of a eating problem. So I'm trying to really fight for them. I'm really, you know, be strong for them. Stick it to the man, you know? I'm gonna try to cheat death with this one a little bit. But yeah, and that's sad things. Pretty much that's my pet tag. So yeah. Bye.